That brings back memories, man. My next guest is a very, very lucky man. His business is fantasy and magic. He works all the time as a writer, a producer, a director. But above all, he's a master puppeteer. Please welcome Jim Henson. You've taken the puppet world to a new height. What's the appeal that your puppets have?
Oh, boy, it's hard to say. I think, I think puppets have a kind of appeal to kids, to adults. They've been around forever. You know, as long as we've had theater, we've had one kind or another of puppetry. But I don't know, I think with the Muppets, there's sort of an innocence to them, you know? Mm-hmm. And I think that's something that appeals to the child in everybody, you know? Because yeah. I think everybody, there's a child in all of us still.
I think the...
Or an adolescence, in the case. Some people.
I am.
Sure.
When you deal with Kermit, I think he's probably the most popular of any puppet on the planet. How did you come up with Kermit?
Oh, he started a long time ago. I made him about 30-some years ago. And he was originally made from an old coat of my mother's. And it was a coat from the rag bag. And
was it a green coat, that color green?
It wasn't that color. No, he was, my mother didn't wear that color green.
Yeah.
But it was more of a sort of a turquoise color.
Yeah, yeah.
And the eyes were a ping pong ball cut in half. It was very simple. It was like a sock puppet, you know.
Right. Have you ever created a character that didn't fly? I mean, something you said, oh, people hated that, or it didn't work?
Yeah. I remember one time, in the early days of Sesame Street, we did a character called Professor Hastings. Mm-hmm. And Professor Hastings was very sort of, he talked real slow. And Frank Oz did him. Frank is really brilliant. And we all cracked up. We thought it was very funny. But we found we just totally bored the audience, you know. Mm-hmm. It was something that just didn't work at all. And
little very kids, intelligent puppet, very
well,
wordy.
Well, what was funny about it was the fact that it was very slow. And we found that kind of speed just didn't work at all.
Yeah. I'd like to talk to Kermit, if it's possible.
Sure. Oh, he's around. So.
Oh, yeah, you know.
They're barking at me.
Yes, they are. That means they like you.
Oh, good. Hi out there. Yes.
Now, first of all,
I haven't been barked at by an audience before, ever. You know? My goodness.
Welcome to the new world, Kermit.
Yeah, that's great. Yeah, yes. ribbit.
Oh, gosh. Let me ask you a question. See, it's weird. I look at you, but I should be... okay.
Yeah, Kermit. It is kind of weird. I've never understood it myself, you know?
Oh, first of all, you work with LeVar, Kermit.
Yeah, oh, sure.
Hiya, Kermit.
How are you, LeVar?
Good to see you, good to see you.
We did Reading Rainbow together.
Yes. Nice. Reading Rainbow fans.
Yeah. That was fun, too.
Between the two of us, we pretty much have PBS children's shows kind of locked up here. You
know? Well, that could be.
Yeah.
Now, Kermit, you're a big star.
Yes.
And you could have any woman you want.
I beg your
pardon. Why Miss Piggy? I've always wanted to ask you, why Miss Piggy?
Why? Well, it's not like I have her, you see. I mean, it's sort of like we work together. This is a professional relationship, I want you to understand, you see.
Okay.
There's nothing intimate or...
Oh.
Could
sexual.
I say? I didn't say that.
Oh.
But we don't say that either. There's nothing. No, this is a working relationship. This is.
You've never like kissed Miss Piggy?
Oh yeah, for the camera.
Nothing ever like in the car on the way home, maybe from a shoot.
You're getting really personal.
We just like to know, you know, how far it's gone. Because a lot of us probably, well, not me, but a lot of us probably fantasize about Miss Piggy because she is a star. It's just I know you can do better.
You fantasize about Miss Piggy?
Well, yeah.
Oh, my goodness. This is news.
Look, I've had worse, man.
Well, Well, I tell you, no, we just kiss. That's all. But okay. But it's a very gentle little thing, and anything more than that, I would use a stunt frog, actually. You see, because I don't do that sort of thing, you see.
Okay. Let me ask you about your money. I know you make a lot of it. What do you do with it?
I don't get anything.
Oh, stop.
No. I get an allowance, you know.
Well, what's your allowance?
It's about $5 a week. Mm-hmm.
I don't know, man. I think you're getting used.
Really?
Because you make a lot of money. I've read what you make. It's more than $5 a week.
You're kidding.
No.
Wait a minute. There's something going on here. Really?
Absolutely.
I was told that PBS doesn't ever pay any money, and I should be honored to be on the show.
We have to talk, man. No.
That's
we
what
have
they
to
said.
Talk
they
after
said
the show.
Yes.
After the show, we'll wrap.
Oh, okay.
Let me ask you another question. You're a big star now. Do people treat you different?
Well, not particularly. No. I don't think so. I get a table at a restaurant now.
Mm-hmm.
You know.
Have you ever wanted, I mean, you've done this a long time. You ever wanted to tell the kids, hey, go learn to read yourself. I'm sick of you.
I never thought of that. No.
You like kids, I'm sure.
Oh, I do. Sure. And we're working as part of this, Reading is Fun campaign, too. You know, we're part of that. To try to get more kids to read, actually.
Well, you're a good guy. See, I tried to throw you there for a minute, but you said the right thing. You're wonderful, and kids love you, and you help a lot.
Oh, well, thank you. Thanks for saying so.
We'll take a commercial. We'll cut. What's something in your throat? Probably some of Miss Piggy's hair.
You're going to do another joke.
We'll take a commercial. We'll come right back.
That was the very first Kermit, and he's slightly different shaped. His body is more like a tube, you know.
That was the first Kermit? I mean, the one made of your mom's coat?
That's the one, yeah. He's traveling, he's over in Europe right now, traveling around in an exhibit called Art of the Muppets. We send around here and there.
Yeah. Can we meet Rowlf?
Sure. See Rowlf the dog?
Just gotta get myself dressed here just a second. There we go. Hey, out there.
All right. Yeah. They like you. Yeah.
That's dog talk.
Yes.
Yes.
You know what they're saying.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, woo-hoo-hoo back at you. Right.
Hey, Rowlf.
Hey, son of a bitch. No, wait, no. That's the nicest thing a dog can say about anybody.
Yeah.
Sure.
Yes.
Oh, yeah.
You're wearing a sling. What's a sling for?
Oh, well, you see, you got to understand the facts of life here. See, I'm a puppet.
Mm-hmm.
I'm a dog. I'm also a puppet, you see?
Yeah.
Okay. Well, now look. See, I got two hands. I got one puppeteer. Okay? He's operating the head.
Mm-hmm.
It's operating the hand.
Yeah. So. Oh, okay. Yeah.
So,
how stupid of me.
Yeah.
You know, I used to watch you a long time ago on the old Jimmy Dean show. Remember that?
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. Now, Jimmy Dean show.
Is it hard for dogs to get work?
Well, yes, it is. I'm glad you brought that up. You know, there aren't many dogs working around these days, you know? Did you see K-9?
Yeah.
Yeah, good film. Jerry Lee, big star, you know? He's a great star, sure, but...
Rowlf.
Hmm?
Jerry Lee?
Yeah, he's a dog in that.
Oh, that's his name. Okay, yeah. See, I thought Jerry Lee Lewis when you said Jerry Lee.
No, Jerry Lee the dog. Jerry Lee the
dog. Do you know that dog? Good.
Well, you know, we've met. We all understand each other, you know. We're part of a little club, you know.
Where'd you meet Jerry Lee?
Let's see, at the, I'm thinking about it. I'll get something after a while. You know, we're part of show business, you know.
I'll tell you what, I'll bail you out. How about singing a song?
Oh, can I do that?
If you'd like to, Mike, can you work with Rowlf?
Oh, sure. I brought a little love song.
Okay.
Sweet little song. It's called You and I and George. It goes like this. You and I and George were strolling through the park one day, and then you held my hand as if to say, I love you. We came to a brook, and George fell in and drowned himself and floated out to sea, leaving you alone with me.
Thank you. Thank you. Yes. They like you, Rowlf.
Right.
Gordy, what do you think?
It was wonderful.
Bravo.
I loved that.
Oh, it was great.
Well, it was pretty good.
Well, it wasn't bad.
Well, there were parts of it that weren't very good,
though. It could have been a lot better.
I didn't really like it.
It was pretty terrible.
It was bad.
We'll be back.
Where did you get